Electrolytic cells and galvanic cells are different from each other. For the MCAT, you're going to have to know that electrolytic cells are coming from an external source. It's non-spontaneous and it consumes electricity. You're going to notice that in every case that the electrons are always going to flow from anode to cathode, whether it is galvanic or electrolytic. In terms of galvanic cells, the energy is going to be released. It's always spontaneous and it generates electricity. Like I said, electrons are flowing from anode to cathode. And specifically, another difference is that the cathode for electrolytic is negative, while the anode is positively charged. But in the galvanic cell, it's going to be what we expect it to be, which is that the cathode is positively charged, while the anode is negatively charged. The anode, in both cases, are going to be the one that are oxidizing. So, oxidizing means losing electrons, right? So there's a salt bridge and there's a voltmeter. Okay, the voltmeter is going to distribute the electrons, while the salt bridges are going to distribute its ions to allow for equilibrium. And that's the differences between electrolytic cells and galvanic cells.